Next up is the controls tab. I highly suggest you check out this tab and tweak it up a bit so it can make your gameplay way better and smoother, you could say. Alright, so there's many ways you can level up on this game. Leveling up, by the looks of it, is super easy. So for those of you who played Beyond, you'll know right off the bat how to get Subjutsu. If you didn't play Beyond, don't worry, I got you. So in order to unlock Subjutsus, you'll need... Hey yo, what's good YouTube? It's your boy TheSummer2 and back with another video. And on today's video, I'm going to be telling you and showing you everything I know and that you need to know about Shinobi Life 2 RPG. So you can play Shinobi Life 2 RPG mode for the first time with a good mindset of how the concept is going to be for that mode. For short, this video is basically a guide, but not any ordinary guide. Because the player in the footage that I'm going to be using in this video is not me. With that being said, I want to take a moment to give a big shout out to probably Azeem. If it wasn't for his Twitch stream that he hosted the day before the release, this video would have never been possible. So make sure you guys go show his Twitch channel some support. The link will be in the description. Before we get into the video, I just want to say Shinobi Life 2 is a game that consists of a lot of content. So in this video, I might not be able to cover everything that's on this game. So if you guys want to see another guide in the future, simply like the video. Alright, so first I'm gonna go over the different types of game modes this game has to offer. RPG mode, which is the mode we're going to be covering on this video, is basically the actual game, which means any player can access this game mode. Moving on to arena mode. Arena mode is basically ABA. I don't know if you guys heard of ABA, which stands for Anime Battle Arena. Anime Battle Arena is basically a game with a diverse selection of anime characters. Each character has its own unique skill set and playstyle. So that's what Anime Battle Arena is. So like I was saying, arena mode is basically Anime Battle Arena, but Naruto version. If that makes any sense. So that's pretty cool. Story mode, you could say it's almost... or a replica of RPG mode, but for the community side, which means not anybody could just access this mode. So there's a whole process you'll have to do in order to get accepted into story mode. You'll have to join different kinds of groups. You also have to join a Discord. It's a whole process. There's a lot of videos out on how to join CC. That's what it's called, closed community, aka story mode. So if you guys are really interested in this game mode and want to get into this game mode and check it out, search up videos on how to get into this game mode, check out those videos and follow the steps, and yeah, just cross your fingers and hope you get accepted. Alright, before you enter the game, you'll need to customize your character. Once you customize your character, I highly recommend you go to the Kikikinkai tab and spin for 2 Kikikinkais. By the way, if you guys bought the KG bag and beyond, you'll get it on Shinobi Life 2 for free. In the video, the creator is currently in the Kikikinkai bag tab. So as you can see, he could equip certain KGs that he got. The ones that are locked, he could end up equipping them and having them in his bag once he spins and gets them. So for those of you that don't know how the bag works, I'm about to explain it for you guys right now. I got you. So let's say you don't have the Sharingan and you spin and you just got the Sharingan, automatically saves into your bag and you could equip it whenever you want. So let's say you got the Sharingan and you end up switching it with another KG and you want to equip the Sharingan again. You won't have to spin for it unless you don't have the bag. If you don't have the bag, then you'll have to spin for it again. But if you have the bag, you could easily go to the bag because it automatically saved once you got it and you could equip it again. Simple. And that's how the KG bag works. Alright, so there's many ways you can level up on this game. Leveling up, by the looks of it, is super easy, I think. One of the ways you can level up is by auto-clicking this branch. Not too hard, right? Super easy. I highly recommend you grind this way if you're a beginner, so you hit level 300. According to one of the game creators on yesterday's stream, he stated a good way to level up for beginners is this branch till they hit level 300. From there, you won't get a good amount of XP from the branch. So it's better to go out in the world and find actual missions. I agree with him because some missions you get from NPCs require you to be a specific level. So if you're a high level and you get a high level mission from an NPC, you'll get a lot of XP from that mission. An amount of XP that usually takes you a while to grind from a branch. That mission also gives you rewards a branch can't give, such as Rio, which is game currency, and other rewards I'm not really sure. I can't really speak on until I actually play the game and do missions myself. If you're the type of person who doesn't like auto-clicking to level up and wants to actually play the game and do missions, there's plenty of low-level missions out there that are super easy. Some low-level missions don't even require you to fight bandits. You'll be doing tasks such as finding things and delivering things, which doesn't sound and look that hard to do. So with that being said, there's two ways you can level up on this game. by grinding on their bench or going around to random NPCs in the village and interacting with them to get missions. Make sure the NPCs you're interacting with have something on top of their head, such as scrolls or a star, I believe, something that looks like a star. And yeah, interact with them and they'll give you quests and missions. The higher level you get, the more moves and skills you can unlock. So make sure to activate your tab by pressing M, I believe, from now and then, and to unlock some moves and add points to your stats. So yeah, stats are very important. So go to the stats tab and add points from now and then, because points are very important. Like I said, they'll affect your health, your mode, I believe, your strength, all that good stuff. So make sure you activate your menu from time to time to add points into your stats and also to unlock moves that you could use to help you in missions. Now, if you activate your menu, you'll see a bunch of tabs. The stat tab is your stats, obviously. When adding points into your stats, you'll have four different options to put your points in. First option is chakra. Second one is ninjutsu. Third one is taijutsu. And the fourth one is health. Right below health, you'll see the amount of points you currently have. Right below points, you'll see what level you are, and right below your level you could see what age you are, and also you have an option to reset your points. Let's move on to the next tab. Ninja tools tab is necessary tools you'll need, such as weapons and other things that I can't show or speak of because I don't know what they are, since I don't have access to the game at the moment, since I'm recording this video a day before the game releases. But I believe that tab has other tools such as potions and other things. I'm not really sure, so I really can't speak on that. Next up is the ninjutsu. So to basically get ninjutsu or unlock the ninjutsu, you basically have to level up. That simple. And each ninjutsu has a specific level, so each ninjutsu will require you to be a specific level in order to unlock and use it. And that's how you basically unlock and get ninjutsu. Next up is going to be Gekkenkai tab. You usually get your Gekkenkai by spending for it in the customization tab. And yeah, I believe that's how you get your Gekkenkai. From there, you just level it up by leveling up and getting XP. And yeah, and when you level it up, you can unlock its moves. And each Gekkenkai, I believe, comes with 3 moves. Next up, Subjutsu. So for those of you who played Beyond, you'll know right off the bat how to get Subjutsu. If you didn't play Beyond, don't worry, I got you. So in order to unlock Subjutsus, you'll need different requirements for specific Subjutsus, such as certain level, certain amount of Ryo, and probably certain amount of points in your stats. But don't worry about the requirements until you actually get the scroll. So check it out, you can't unlock a Subjutsu unless you find it. In order to find it, you'll need to wait a certain amount of time. Each Subjutsu has a different spawn time and also different location where they spawn. Once they spawn, go to the location where they spawn and get them, and that's how you get a Subjutsu. Once you get it, then that's when you'll need to worry about the requirements you need in order to unlock. And then once you meet the requirements, that's when you can unlock the Subjutsu, and that's how you get a Subjutsu. And yeah, that's simple. Next up is the companions tab. So in the companions tab, you'll find companions. So there's different types of companions, such as Pain companion, Sasuke companion, etc. In order to unlock companion, I believe you unlock them with Ryo. I'm not really sure yet, so don't take my word. Next up is the villages tab. So in this tab, you could teleport to different types of villages in the map, and you could also teleport to the main menu of the game, and you could also teleport to your friend if he's in game. That's pretty cool if you ask me. Next up should have been mastery, but since I don't have any footage or pictures of that tab, we're going to skip it and move on to the cheats tab, aka game pass tab. Remember when the creator said that they're going to be having some game passes from their previous Naruto games put onto this game? Well, by the looks of it, all these game passes are from their previous games. If you bought the Akasa game pass back in Beyond, I don't think you'll need to buy it for Shinobi Life 2. If you bought the radio back in Shinobi Life days, I don't think you'll need to buy it for Shinobi Life 2. Same goes for the other game passes. Let's take a moment to look at these game passes. The KG game passes are hella broken if you ask me. Imagine someone having 4 different KGs or 3 different KGs compared to someone who has 2 KGs. That's hella broken. No wonder they named this tab cheats. Next up, customs tab. So this tab allows you to make custom things, such as a custom mask. In order to make a custom mask, you'll need the customs game pass. Next up is the controls tab. I highly suggest you check out this tab and tweak it up a bit so it can make your gameplay way better and smoother, you could say. The If you haven't joined my Discord server, click the first link in the description and join up. Cop my fire merch, click the merch link in the description and cop up. I'm hosting a giveaway. The prize is going to be a surprise. In order to enter the giveaway, you'll have to smash the like button on the video, subscribe and turn on notifications, and leave a comment in the comment section below. Make sure your comment has this hashtag. I'm going to be announcing the winners in my Discord server in the giveaway channel. So if you haven't yet, join my Discord. It's been your boy, the Solomon21. Peace out.